Hey everyone, welcome to Brick Vault. Today is another LEGO Weekly News update. Plenty of things happened in the world of LEGO this week, including set reveals, as well as a little bit of a controversy with a LEGO Ideas contest winner. Anyways, we're gonna get into all of that, but the very first thing, like always, is the Amazon deals of the week.
As per request of the viewer, these are the Amazon sales of the week. I haven't actually checked them as of the moment I'm recording this, so just assume whatever set pictures you see right up there are indeed on sale. The links are in the description below. And let's jump into what I suppose is the top story of the week. We've got some new sets that have been revealed. I'd like to start off with the new Jurassic World sets, and specifically the Jurassic Worlds line also gave birth to a new Jurassic Park set. Very much like how the last new Indiana Jones movie came out, they released some sets that were based on the original trilogy. Here is a Jurassic Park set. It's called Jurassic Park Velociraptor Chase. The minifigs included are Alan Grant, Ellie Sattler, Lex Murphy, Tim Murphy, and a Velociraptor. Specifically, the play area is a combination of the control room, the kitchen, as well as the embryo cold storage room, and there's a ton of fun little things to notice. Just about every little corner of this set has a reference to a particular scene. I think my favorite little details that I noticed right off the bat is the table with the jello, and it's awesome that the shaving cream, the fake shaving cream embryo sort of stealing device is stuck in the cold storage as well. There's plenty of fun little Easter eggs. I like the stickers that are on the computer screens. And let me know what other scene references that you see in this particular set. I know I was sort of rattling off to Mike. He doesn't really know the movie that well. I knew pretty much everything, or I think I know everything that's hidden away here. And also the box art for the Jurassic World sets has been revealed. And this is something that was pretty interesting. I didn't notice the first time around when I was taking a look at the official images of the sets a week or two ago. But you can see in the back, we've got some set numbers as well as different dinosaurs and all their parts, and it says you can build your own hybrid. That's really fun. That's kind of a sort of a fun incentive, I suppose, for people to get multiple different sets, and it kind of ties in well with the kind of theme that we get from the Jurassic World series, where they're actually splicing a bunch of different DNA together with dinosaurs, and that's kind of the crux of the problem, so to speak. So that's a creative way for LEGO to kind of market the sets, and it definitely ties in really well with the theme of the movies. This set is going to retail for $40, and the next set that was revealed is the Dilophosaurus Outpost Attack. It's 289 pieces, and included are three minifigs, a full-grown Dilophosaurus, as well as a baby one. Seems to have a few different play features, like breaking off the gate and swinging the cage around, but I'm definitely not as intrigued by this set as the previous one, just because I am a bigger fan of the Jurassic Park movie, and not quite as much the Jurassic World. Also, as a technicality, you can see the official box art as well as the official images for the Jurassic World line. I'll leave a link at Alan Tran's website if you guys want to check them out. And also a new set from the Fantastic Beasts, The Crimes of Grindelwald, has a new set coming out for that movie, and it's called Grindelwald's Escape. This here features that new wand piece for the characters, which we first saw from the new Harry Potter set that's been announced recently, but I'm definitely most intrigued with this Threstrial Beast that we have in the front. It's a great looking mold that makes up the head. I love that we've got wings attached to it. It's been a long time since we've had a winged beast carrying or pulling a carriage. So it kind of throws me back to maybe some old school LEGO sets that I really liked. And anyways, the final part count is 132 pieces, and it's going to retail for $20. You tell me if you think the price point is worth it. I have a feeling it's a little bit expensive because of this unique Threstrial character in the front. And I suppose it's really all just kind of in the eyes of the beholder. There's definitely new prints for the minifigs, but let's move on to the Brickheads Go. There are official pictures now for just more detailed pictures. I know that the initial pics were taken from Toy Fair. Now the official parts are around. You can now make your own characters, and with the parts it looks like you can make like a LEGO Brickheads hipster. At least that's the sample guy that we've got here in front, as well as somebody that looks like they're kind of dressed like a Powerpuff Girl. Anyways, I do think this is a fun concept in general. Sets that inspire creativity are always a little bit more fun, and the Brickheads line seems very accessible to all kinds of builders, so I certainly hope that this set does well and LEGO is incentivized to maybe make more like it in the future. Oh, and here's another quick reveal. I saw this earlier as a leak on Reddit, but it looks like it's an official release now. I'm pretty sure I can show the pictures. These are the official images for the new Jurassic World's Brickheads. It's a two character in one pack with Owen, and the first beast version of any type of Brickheads Pinhead's figure blue. I think the detailing for Owen or Chris Pratt's character is fine, but mostly I'm looking forward to getting a Brickhead's version of a Velociraptor. For my own personal aesthetic, I think it's a little bit too cutesy, but I suppose they kind of have to keep it in this sort of simplified Brickhead's fashion. I think it's pretty fun though. It is set number 4164 and it is gonna sell for $20. Now this next story is almost kind of a non-story. I picked it up at thebrickfan.com from Alan Tran, and he also cites another forum on Brickset. But basically there has been a little bit of a kerfuffle when it comes to the Ideas Moments in Space contest winner. Some people are saying that the person who won the Ideas contest, the builder being MJ Smiley, that they took the concept or they took the design from an older little set that already existed. Apparently this came out for a 2016 LEGO Brand Manager retail conference. And honestly, I haven't even gone through sort of the actual feed of comments myself, because I just looked at the two different pictures and I can tell right off the bat that, or at least this is my opinion, but I really do think that MJ Smiley didn't steal anything from this design. If you really do look close at the rocket or the base of the coin-operated machine, it looks like just about, I mean, it looks like 100% of this build really is original. The rocket was approached in a completely different way. No part of the rocket actually resembles any other part of one from back in 2016. And the same goes for the base part, the coin-operated bit of the machine down below. The connection point between the rocket and the machine is different, and even the walls and everything, all the dimensions have completely changed. I'm calling this a non-traversy. You guys let me know what you think in the comment section below, but personally, I think it's a little bit of hot water. This is an original build, and congratulations once again to the winner of the contest, MJ Smiley. Cool, good job. Anyways, moving on. The new Hulkbuster Ultron version, that giant sort of Ultimate Collector Series set. The designer video is now out. I've already built the set. The review for that is coming out next week. All I'm saying is look close at the video, and the designers almost never stop holding this set in any of the shots. I'm just saying that's a very sort of telling little bit of detail. I think the video is good though. It's worth checking out. And in related, not so related news, the talented builder ChubbyBots released a video on a modification for the Hulkbuster, and I also think it is worth checking out that video as well. That's all I'm gonna say. And staying on the topic of newly released videos, LEGO has released this tiny little teaser trailer for the new Tron idea set that's coming out very soon. It doesn't look like they've changed too much of the base model from what the original design was, and this new set number 21314 is coming out in April, so it's pretty soon. Now, I know Mike mentioned this in the last video, that a significant number of the Toys R Us stores are shutting down, but it seems that this week the official announcement came out. It looks like all of the Toys R Us stores are shutting down, which is too bad. People were basically saying that this was gonna happen or had already happened for the last week, but officially it has been announced that, yeah, Toys R Us is no more, and I just thought I would share this guy's picture that he posted up on Reddit. Thank you, Roger Gons, for posting this. It captures my emotions perfectly. Also coming from Reddit this week, there is a price for the new Ideas Voltron set. It's going to be selling for €180. And that's a pretty big set. I mean, the price is big. I don't know what the parts are or what the heck the set's going to look like, but it definitely gives you an idea that, yeah, it's going to be a big set. That's not really much of a surprise. And that giant Technic Bucati Chiron set that was supposed to be released for August has now been pushed back to June. Let's jump into LEGO Ideas now. If you don't know much about LEGO Ideas, it's a website in which you submit your own LEGO creations in hopes to having it become an official LEGO set. And I was just on LEGO Twitter recently. There are 4 projects currently at 9,000 votes. I have a feeling probably all of them eventually will get to the 10,000 mark. Personally, I like the vintage motorcycle BMW R62 the best. And currently, I think there's actually a lot of good sets for LEGO Ideas right now that you can vote on. Bricky Brick has an awesome history museum. It's really tall. It's a corner piece, and it looks really, really great and ornate on the outside with these nice arched windows, plus an extremely intricate and very elaborate interior, kind of like a Night at the Museum sort of build. Anyways, if you guys want to check those out, all of the things I've been talking about, including the idea sets, are linked in the description below.
All right, that is it for this episode, everybody. Thanks a lot for watching. Remember, if you enjoy our content, you can always like or subscribe. Tomorrow is Mike's Top 10 Mocks of the Week episode, where he talks about the coolest things people were building out of Lego in the last week. It's always a fun episode for us. I think you guys should check it out. Anyways, that is it for this episode. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time at Brick Vault.